All right, it's time for Seen and Unseen, where we expose the big cultural stories of the day. All the lamestream media is peddling Melania conspiracy theories, why late night comedy is dead, and musicians versus politicians. Is that a softball game? All right, joining us now, all the details, Raymon Arroyo, Fox News contributor, New York Times best-selling author, brand new book, Will Wilder, The Amulet of Power. All right, Raymon, why are the gals at The View spreading conspiracy theories about the First Lady? Can she take any more abuse by these people?
This one is really unbelievable. Over the weekend, the president and the First Lady toured Alabama to console victims of those terrible tornadoes. They took dozens of lives. Stories started spreading on the internet claiming that this was not Melania at the president's side, but a body double. Joy Behar and the ladies of The View cleared it up this way.
That one does not look like her. Sorry. I wasn't going to go along with this, but that one in that picture doesn't look
like her. I know. You weren't going to go. Now you will.
No, it's a different shaped face.
You know, I spent like an, I'm ashamed to say, I spent like an hour on Saturday involved in this.
That's her.
Melania is a very tall, statuesque woman. And the one that we saw, the first one that we showed, she looks kind of short.
When there's a rumor like this and memes all over the place, I think it catches on because there's an element of truth to the idea that she doesn't want to spend time with him.
Okay, let me just say, Joy, I haven't been on The View in a long time. I haven't been on The View in a long time. Invite me on. We'll do a little comparison of photos.
An element of truth.
Truth?
An what is the element of truth except your own ideology, where there's obviously a bias against this First Lady?
You're kidding.
Stephanie Grisham, the First Lady spokesman, came out and said this is shameless, particularly when they were there to console victims of a terrible
tragedy. And it was beautiful.
The
First, they trashed Trump for signing Bibles.
Signing the Bibles,
because people
which we're going to get into on Fox Nation.
We're going to get it on Fox Nation, because I wanted to talk about that.
Right.
But the other thing about this is I can't believe they promoed their next segment, I guess tomorrow, on the fact that we really didn't land on the moon.
coming up.
Yeah, the moon landing was faked, too.
But now, Laura, I heard on the internet that Joy Behar occasionally employs a body double. Look at that. Now, look, I'm sure that only has an element of the truth to it. We'll leave it there.
Oh, man.
Dustin Hoffman's going to get royalties on that one. Speaking of comedians, there is a related story. Jay Leno, Joy. Jay Leno was on the Today Show. You opened yourself up to it. And Jay was talking this week about whether he missed late night TV. His answer was telling.
I don't miss it. You know, everything now is, if people don't like your politics, everyone has to know your politics. Now it's all very serious. Everything is just so I just like to see a bit of civility come back to it, you know? I mean, all the comics, Jimmy and Colbert and everybody else, it's tough when that's the only topic
everything.
Out there.
Yeah.
They've made it about this, Laura. They've made it all about politics, and the audience is fleeing from it. This is why the overall audience is way down from when Jay Leno, or God forbid, Johnny Carson, was presiding over The Tonight Show. It is a ruin, and I think it's because not only has the comedy, as Jay said, gotten nasty and petty and very political.
And unfunny.
Well,
it's not funny.
This is the cardinal sin. It's not funny, and it's the very thing comedy should teach us, what we have in common and have us laugh together.
At each other, too.
Rather, it accentuates the things that divide
us,
and half the audience runs away.
Carson said this years ago.
Right.
When before he died, he said, I never thought I should spout off about politics. I'm here to make people laugh.
Right.
I'm here to entertain them. Shut up and make us laugh.
Make us laugh, yeah.
All right, well, Joy Behar actually makes our point, or Jay Leno's point, about this. She said this today.
I did stand-up up until Obama came in, and then I was losing interest because he was too good. And there was nothing to make fun of there.
Yeah,
with
right.
Bush, it was a bonanza.
There it is. She loved Obama, but Bush and Trump are a cornucopia. There's plenty of humor to have on both sides. A good comedian should make all of those
parenting?
Points.
Dating, all sorts of things about life.
Foibles aplenty.
So, Jerry Seinfeld could make us laugh about the socks and the dryer.
By the way,
why do we
always
have one
sock?
Are
the three most popular comedians out there? Kevin Hart, Seinfeld, and Jay Leno. Laura,
bingo.
A battle has been brewing since the Reagan administration between musicians and politicians about using songs for political rallies. You know, the songs that become anthems for a campaign like these.
There ain't no doubt I love this land.
No, I'm not gonna raise my
Elizabeth Warren has run into some hot water for using that Dolly Parton hit. Apparently, her spokesman said, her manager, we did not approve the request, and we do not approve requests like this of a political nature. Now, Laura, the law on this is kind of dodgy. Remember, Bruce Springsteen went after Ronald Reagan. Tom Petty went after George Bush for using their songs. The law is, if a venue has the music rights,
ASCAP
broadcast, you know, performance rights, they can play it in the arena. But if it's broadcast, the musician has some publicity rights because they say this looks like a false endorsement.
I got it.
That's where you get into some problems.
Okay.
But many of Queen, REM, Adele, The Stones, they've all sent cease and desist letters to Donald Trump. He hasn't stopped using the song.
What's the enforcement mechanism? I still don't get, you can't always get what you want, but you get what you need.
I don't either. Why is that
the anthem?
I don't understand. I hope you pick something else.
I mean, Bush is taking care of business. We got to go back to Bachman Turner Overdrive in 1974 to get that music.
Pick somebody dead. That's the anthem.
Right,
pick
a dead.